Medicine's gone. What the fuck does that mean for anything? I don't know, but the legendaries are coming. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in with us. We're wonky, aren't we?
No, you're wonky, mate. Yeah. I'm like sat next door.
Yeah, ladies. Sorry, mate. I was honestly, we were in a bit of a rush.
I know, mate.
Because we were, what were we doing today, mate?
We were being Paw Patrol,
we
mate.
Were Paw Patrol today. Here's the picture. Although I think we did kind of reveal who we were.
I didn't.
I think if I show the stream my desktop, they would actually cry.
Don't show it then.
I think I need to.
No.
Is that the picture?
Yes. Yeah,
that's the picture. Check it out, boys and girls. Yeah, that's me and Mr. Ghosty. Check it out for my boy's birthday. Them costumes, though.
Man, they were hot.
They were hot.
Hot. No, do you know what the worst part is? I got collared after I got changed out of it by a woman who said, you need to put your costume back on because people want pictures
of you. I dropped you into that because I don't know how it was in your costume because we didn't really have a chance to talk about it because there was loads going on. We had 27 kids at that party. 20 fucking 7 kids. But I couldn't see at all. Like,
right, I couldn't.
I had a visibility of about 1%. Well, I had a guide for the first part and I was walking around and then she abandoned me. And I was like, fuck, I don't know where I'm going. So what I had was a glimmer of through the mouth about that big and I had to like do that. Yeah. And I was really wanting to own it up, but I also had the strap across to the side of my face. And I was ill, which sucked. So I was like trying to own it up and wanted to go around with the kids. And no, wasn't happening. So I was the second person to take the costume off. Big Deuce was like, yeah, I'm Ryder. Laters, mate. And then he just went and fucking took his costume off. Then I took mine off because I was like dying in that costume. And couldn't see. I really wanted to play around, but I did get a picture with Maxine. I just went like this near kids. And they high-fived me and I was like, nailed it. And then I turned around and you and my brother were like all over the place center, like, yeah, we're the Paw Patrol, mate. And you had a guide, which fucking blew because I wanted to stay in it. Honestly, I did.
But they're furries, mate.
Oh, they said to Emma afterwards it was the most ridiculous thing they've ever seen because we were all over 6 foot. Said all these 6 foot guys dressed up as puppies. They'd never seen anything like it. They said they were
moist.
I wondered why they weren't going away because they're only about 15 years old, those girls. But one day they will be tidy.
Oh, yeah, they will be.
But not today. But not today. And they were in the room watching us get dressed and stuff. But it was cool. It was cool. It was a good day. I wish I wasn't poorly. Because everyone kept trying to give me a kiss. Like, you know, the bums and stuff were like, eh. And I was like, don't come near me. I'm fucking dying. Stay away from me. And they were like, oh, right. Gross. I'm like, yeah, I know. Thank you very much. It just happens to be my kid's birthday party. There's nothing I can do about it. So I was high as fuck on flu tablets. It was well good. And then it started wearing off and I was dying at the end of it, which was cool as fuck. Right, you want to see my desktop? Fine.
Don't do it.
There you go. Drink this in. There you go. That's what my desktop currently looks like.
I hate you.
How good's that? You loving it? Yeah, man. That's what it looks like right now because we're working on so many fucking videos and my organization is rotten. Absolutely rotten making so many videos at once. Please, no! Oh my god. The horror triggered. I cry. I told you! I fucking told you, man. That's what it looks like when you're editing so many videos because we have to keep the legacy on there for ages because we make tweaks to it after the Patreon
set. Oh god, you asshole.
Not that bad, bro. Bro, that's awful. That is fucking awful. All those audio clips, I've seen worse. Yeah, I'm sure you've seen worse, but that is an actual operating... I can't wait to see it's clear. We've got to finish this video where I went undercover, which was just the best thing ever. Going undercover in WoW is amazing.
I never thought about doing it. I should do it.
Well, we had got an interesting video coming out on Monday where I went in with one... Because you were listening to me while I was making it. I was like, this isn't working. This isn't what I expected to find at all. This is totally fucked up. What we're doing... I went undercover for a specific mission... And Blizzard's fucked it all up, and I can't do what I'm trying to do.
Oh, in a good way.
In a good way. But it was nice. I was in 6 guilds in total. Undercover in 6 guilds, which was amazing. I joined the best Greek guild ever. Oh, yeah. The Greeks.
Crisp.
950 members, 7 online. Keeping it real for the team. They were fucking awesome. So, yeah, that's coming out on Monday, which should be interesting. I don't think many people will watch that one, but it should be good. We had the Legacy come out, which you guys seem to like. And we did the thing that we've been planning to do, which was didn't put a title on it. And I think that went down really well. I did like that the Patreon guys were like, I didn't care, because I already knew. Yeah, well, no fucking shit, you already knew. Smart asses.
Or the complete, like, idiocy of the
the people who thought we'd fucked it up.
Maybe you should put the proper title of the video in the title. It's like, even if you open that video, you click on that video, mate, there's a thing, the top line of the info, which is visible on the screen right underneath the video, says full title will be added into it.
In fact, I've probably
hours.
Got to remove that. I don't think I've deleted that line.
You haven't.
Yeah, I've got to remove that. But yeah, I thought that was cool. There's never any fucking surprise with YouTube. Never. And the best thing about, like, I don't know. I mean, maybe it's kind of childish, but I think it's true. It's like, when I saw The Matrix, I'm not comparing our video to The Matrix or anything, but I didn't know what The Matrix was about at all. So I went in completely unaware of what it was about. And then I came out just like, being unprepared made that so much better. And instead of like reading it and researching it, all that kind of stuff. So most people are going to watch a video that's called Legacy. So I thought, we'll risk it and see what happens. Yeah. And because you find out within the first 30 seconds. Oh, some people told me they spent like half the video thinking it was Legacy of the Death Knight. Oh, that I was quitting WoW. Mate, the immediate comments that I was quitting WoW.
The best comment is by some fucking self-righteous prick who put something like, the intro where it says like, you know, 4 years, man. It's like, so it's obviously it's before Wrath came out, like 4 years.
Yeah.
It's like, only been playing for 4 years, lol, and you make guides. And I was like...
It's the best, man. It's the absolute fucking best. I love shit like that. I love the guys who just watched the first 10 seconds, paused it, and then wrote about me quitting WoW and stuff like that. But that was cool. Yeah, I think it went over really well. We're never going to beat that kind of effect, which is amazing. We're not going to do that on the next Legacy, though, because the Legacy that comes out in about a week's time is about a different game, and I don't want to entrap people. And then we're for the guys who came to PreachCon. So we've got another Legacy coming out in about a week's time. It's about a different game. And then we're making the one that we filmed at PreachCon. So you guys know what that is. No spoilers. People haven't really spoiled it so far.
No, I've seen a couple of comments, but nothing's been spoiled, mate. So
just people asking where it is. I haven't seen anything say. Yeah, I mean, we've got our schedule is down and tight at the moment. We're two full time now, and there's no slacking involved. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Anyway, Rip Metzen, your thoughts, chat. He's out of there. Your thoughts, Andy. Oh, you know what we should also bring up before people answer that? Oh, no, I'll talk about it.
What?
Well played, Metzen. I couldn't be more than happy for anyone who's like, I've made loads of money. I've got three kids.
Oh, yeah,
I'm going to go and enjoy myself.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Obviously, it doesn't...
How could
that? It sort of... It puts it into the air about his voice characters.
He's coming back to do it. He said that. He's going to do
he?
Yeah, he's going to do the voice work.
Okay, he's just not working there as a day-to-day. He's coming back.
Yeah,
back
he's just not doing it. I think,
right,
I
for
think,
me then, fucking yeah. Fuck yeah.
I think Overwatch was his baby. Overwatch has done well.
You see the statue? Well jealous, mate.
Whose statue?
They're doing Mets in a statue,
oh,
right?
No, I haven't seen that.
Mate, you know have you seen the first Overwatch video? I can't remember what it's fucking called as well. It's the one where Winston calls him back. When Reaper tries to.
Sure.
Well, basically, it goes back in time when Winston was a little kid. With Dr. Winston, mate. And he's holding Dr. Winston's hand and Winston shows him the... there you go.
Oh, so
it's a fucking belt. So they're showing him the picture of it. This is what your statue is going to be. And
Well good. I'll bring it up for you now, guys.
It's so fucking cool.
Yeah, Overwatch was his baby. And Overwatch has done well and he's happy to go now. That's cool. That's awesome. Aw. I feel a bit mosh, mate.
I feel a bit jealous, mate. Cunt.
A little bit jealous. Who are we on there?
It's a really good statue, though.
Yeah, it's really good. I do need to catch up on my Overwatch videos. I am behind. I watched the Bastion one.
Recall, it is Recall, yeah.
Yeah, that is really cool. It's a Disney statue. Oh, you see? You get all the feels now when you see that, don't you? That's awesome.
It's
well played
like the Disney statue, absolutely right, because it's got Walt Disney holding Mickey Mouse's hand, hasn't it?
Ah.
See what you did there,
we've probably
Blizzard.
Seen that. We've been to Disneyland. Disney
I proposed in front of it.
Was it in front of that statue?
Yeah, because it's halfway down the promenade. And the statue's in the background, and the castle's in the background.
I fucking hated Disney.
Robin,
Mickey, Mouse, Fink, cunt.
Dirty fucking wallet-like snatchers. But the actual...
Robin bastards, man.
I like the stuff that we actually did there with the whole princesses and the bippity-boppity-boot.
Well, you had a little girl. Yeah. So, yeah, it was great for you. Fucking wank for me. I just had to take my boy on It's a Small World over and over again. I wanted to kill someone. Disneyland is hell. War is hell. Disneyland. Oh, the fireworks display is fucking cool. So yeah, Rip Metzen, I think he's good. He hasn't had a major role in WoW for a while, as far as I know. He does the, you know, he does the voices and stuff. But I think Overwatch has been his baby for a long time, and that's done well. So it's fair play. Solid. And we also lost. Who was it? What's his name? Craig Am I, the quest guy.
Is that like Bill Nye, the science guy?
No, he's the quest guy.
I don't know.
I don't want to be rude. I mean, he's been the quest guy for like 10 years or some shit.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
I feel bad about not knowing who
it's not
is.
Surprising. People are always like, is Blizzard dying? No, man. These guys have been there for like 20 years, yeah. Bro. Like fucking 20 years they've been doing that fucking job. Fucking, that's a long time to be in one job, bro.
Went to Disney World on my honeymoon this summer. Mickey hit on my wife while I was at the buffet. Cocksucker.
Well, you never had that happen.
Wow.
So does that mean...
I should have done that dressed like Chase, mate, today.
I got skipped in the queue because I was wearing an Ultimate Warrior t-shirt as provided by one of the audience.
Yes.
Yeah, Wendy sent us a t-shirt for Ultimate Warrior. The guy saw it and went, come on. Got straight to the magic thing. Yeah, he's loading his retirement, which is very cool. Right then. So we did a video yesterday about them oranges. Them oranges.
Oh, the legendaries.
Yeah, so as you start getting your ideas together for that. I mean, we originally actually had a different intro to that because we did the back and forth intro. It's the first time we've actually utilized both cameras in sync, which was surprisingly easy to do.
That was very funny.
But our original intro for that was that we were going to be like, I just don't give a shit. Well, that was what our original intro was for that. And I thought we were going to trigger everybody if we were just like, I don't care. I just don't care. Because that was our response. That was our, when we found out about it, we were like, I just don't care at all. I don't care, whatever. So we changed it a little bit to be like, well, yeah, obviously. Fuck everything about the system. Who's benefiting from this oranges, the legendary system? Who?
It's a bad idea.
It was always bad.
I know.
Always.
I don't. The thing is, though, for me personally, it's been the third expansion in a row where it's like legendary. It's like, I don't care.
That's
really
what I'm saying. I just
no
don't
more.
Give a shit anymore.
It's not legendary. It's an arbitrary requirement for fucking pugs. That's all it is. That's all your legendary is. It's an arbitrary requirement for later pugs.
I just want to know, what are we fucking... What issue did we solve? Was it better?
Expect it, though, for fucking pug raids, mate.
Did anybody get 4? I know it was several people who got 3. That's what at this point it's like, I just don't care anymore. I don't care about the shitty system. If I get a crap one, whoop-de fucking do. I just don't give a shit. And I think a lot of people are starting to get the bad, but it's orange. But I don't think I think people are starting to come around to the idea that having an orange doesn't fucking mean anything.
Well, look at it like this, mate. They did that with Epics. That's why
that's all right.
But we coined the term. I'm talking like probably even back to Wrath now. Welfare Epics.
Yeah, that was the same with Vanilla, though. People, that rose, the rose-tinted argument about Welfare Epics is embarrassing.
But
honestly.
No, what I'm saying is, that's obviously, that's set in now. It's like, well, Epics aren't really Epic anymore, so we need to pick on fucking
It's not even the fact that they're orange that I'm bringing up here. I'm just thinking about this system of acquiring very powerful items completely randomly and arbitrarily throughout the game. I mean, it's supposed to make you excited.
It isn't.
It's not exciting. It really isn't. It's frustrating more than anything.
Yeah.
It's just a frustrating experience. If I get one, fine. But other than that, it's like, it's just a frustrating experience. It's not exciting in the least. Especially if you get the bad ones, which there are bad ones. Where you're like, Jesus Christ. I just, for the moment this was announced, it was clearly never going to be work. And of all the things, and this is what sucks, of all the things to fuck up code-wise, the legendary shouldn't have been the thing.
No.
They should not be fucking that up. That's just fucking ridiculous. It's just so fucking shit. I don't understand. And therefore, we went on to... Cosmetic would have been great. Well, talking of cosmetics, I wanted to bring this up with you guys. So, before we get into balance, who's after weird artifact skins? Because you are.
Yeah.
And you've uncovered... Demon Hunters have uncovered a lot. I don't know any of mine whatsoever, but you keep bringing up that there's ones from archaeology or something?
No. Well, there's two Demon Hunter skins. Like, hidden skins.
What are the hidden skins?
One of them is basically, like, a skull on the front of it, and the side of it looks like it's made out of a jawbone.
Okay.
The other one is a shield in the middle of it, and the fucking glaives are made out of fire.
So where does yours come from, hidden?
Second one, I've not found a reveal for it. The first one is a short quest, but I think, could be wrong, you've got to get a drop.
Oh, right, a rare drop that starts a little quest.
Yeah, but I think the drop is, it's just like, I don't know if it labels itself as a quest drop or if it's something like that, but...
So are you guys all looking for these skins? What I'm really enjoying about Legion right now is I have about 4 things in my bag that I don't know what they do. And I'm not going to wowhead it. But it's just like, you need to get three or four more little pieces of this thing to make something happen. I'm like, all right, that's pretty fucking cool. The fire one isn't released yet. So I'm like, whoa, am I hearing this right? There are rare unlockable skins in the game for some classes and not for others.
So I think some have two, some have one. I don't think there's a class that doesn't have one yet. Maybe there is, maybe there isn't, but yeah.
Are they good?
Well, I want second. No, I'm not just collecting for the sake of it, because some of the skins I couldn't give a fuck about. Like, there is an example, mate. The PvP Havoc one, where it's got the inverted sort of Delta Wing glaive. Don't give a shit
about any of the colours.
Or any of the colours, no. But here's the thing. The Monk PvP one for Windwalker, where it's a set of fucking katana blades. Yes, please.
Yes, please. I'll take it.
That's the question. Sorry, can I just throw this into the background of the chat? If I'm a Mistweaver on my Monk, do I have to unlock that PvP skin in Windwalker, the PvP blades, or can I be PvPing as a Mistweaver and it just does it through the three classes? That's what I need to know.
That's a good point. I have Hulk hands on my Windwalker. The BM one's at a vendor, you just buy it. We're sorry. That's the BM one, it's just the guy you go to, he goes, we're so sorry, so sorry. No, it's cross-spec.
Yes, so I can actually heal and then get the Katana Blade. Deal, mate, deal.
Yeah, as Gaz said, there's so much to keep going with, which is a lot of stuff. The Fire Mage Hidden Artifact Appearance has not been discovered yet. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
That's unheard of in WoW. That is fucking unheard of, that there's stuff that we just don't know how to do yet.
It's sort of like the rumours of fishing up Ashbringer in vanilla. How do we get it?
How do we get it? Hopefully I'll find it. But yeah, I'm impressed that they're doing that stuff. I don't care, as you can imagine. But that is some very cool stuff for people. Oh my god.
Ghosty, will you be sad if you can transmog artifact weapons after Legion? I think we said this in the live stream, is you'd be a fool to think you're keeping those after this expansion.
Oh yeah. But whether or not you'll keep the appearances is a different question.
That's a good point. But yeah, the thing is, you've got at least fucking, what should we say, 2 years to enjoy it. So
we're not doing whatever.
It.
Isn't the Fire Mage one on WoWhead? Maybe they found the skin, but they don't know how you get it.
Yeah.
There you go. There are two hidden appearances for every spec, but one is gated behind 7.1, which again is really fucking weird. Raiders, they're opening the raid testing for the next raid pretty soon, including Karazhan and the Trial of Valor. On the PTR. Before we've got we're just about to start the first raid, and raid testing is announced for the next raid already. What do you think about that? Are we going the other way here? Are we rushing a little bit? I don't want to be raid testing when the new raid's just opened up.
Raid testing when the raid's opened up?
Yeah, the raid gonna be opening raid testing for the Trial of Valor and Karazhan. Like, is it Monday? Yeah. This is the next raid.
And the Wednesday is when our raids go live.
Yeah.
Fuck that then. No.
Raid more or casual, mate. There you go. You wanted more content? There it is. There's a point where it's like too much, right?
I'm so happy with the level of content right now. I think there's only been two things that annoy me at the minute, like in this game, and both of them are, I think, singular quests. That's it. I've got absolutely no other problems with the game so far.
Is it still, you're still going on about that leatherworking quest?
I didn't mention it specifically, but now that you mentioned it, mate, fuck that leatherworking quest. But no, if I was to pick a gripe, and this is just being picky, is high mountain quests that require you to go all the way around a mountain range just to find the path that goes all the way back up to the mountain range, which leads to the other side of the map. That's it, man. That's it.
So you hate high mountain and you hate that level of
quest. I don't hate it. I just don't like that, you know?
Fuck that moose. Yeah. Moose quest so much. But you've done it, right? It's over with.
I've done it, yeah.
You can relax. You can get... Nomi is the worst. Nomi would have been so much better if it wasn't just burnt.
Remind me.
Nomi is the cooking vendor who burns all your food.
Oh, that piece of shit. He should not be allowed to take more than one of your items if he's just going to burn the piss out of them.
Why is he burning them? Like, he could have got it wrong and it's sour, it's too bitter. You know, something like that. Slightly bitter, slightly sour, slightly crunchy, slightly undercooked. Something like that would have been fine. Why is it all burnt?
Or, if it was smart, say, like, if I gave him some ribs, like, and he gave back, like, you know, I kind of made a partial recipe with it. I need another try. So it gives you you need three fragments of a recipe. So it's like, if you do that three times, you combine them and you get a recipe from that
Nomi's
product.
A bell end, man. And he seems so smug about it, because sometimes he gives you two of the same recipe.
You fat panda prick.
Doesn't he? Like, you wait around forever for a recipe and then he gives you two of the same and he's just like, deal with it. Deal with it, motherfucker.
But he just puts it on the table and he's like...
It's burning it is the sign of a bad cook. Burning food isn't what a chef should be doing.
Yeah.
Getting the flavor combination wrong, yeah, that's fine. Burning it, though, that's just fucked up. That just means you're a shit chef. But they fixed my Onyx. Are you with me, brothers? You know why that is a fucking thing. Did you know about this fucking cat in Suramar? This cat fuck?
No.
There's a fucking rare in Suramar, right? This cat prick. He has like a 90% chance to drop the crit food recipe when you kill him for the first time.
After you kill him the first time, it goes down dramatically.
It dropped to like 1%. So I didn't get it. I was like, you motherfucker. And that's where you get the big crit food recipe from. And I was like, you fucking prick. And then Blizzard was like, no, he can still drop it. I just stood there killing him for so long.
I remember you doing it. I was there when you was doing it.
For
you
so
had it on your second
long.
Screen, working, waiting for it to respawn. Then you go...
Because he respawns like every 2 minutes. And he just fucking stood there going, nope, not today, motherfucker. Not fucking today. So we do have Mythic Plus coming next week. And they're going to loot cap it at 850 for the first week. Don't want you spamming it, I guess is the idea.
The point is for it to be spam, though, right?
They don't really want it to be spam. They want it to be a weekly thing where you do Mythic plus 10. That way you get your best chest.
That's hog shit, though. That's what Mythics are. Mythics are once weekly. This Mythic Plus was supposed to be... If you're going to copy Diablo, don't be a prick about it and copy Diablo. It's supposed to be a spammable thing to see how high you can get. Now
I'm okay with this. You can still do them up to the higher levels.
I fucking hate the people who do this.
No, I think this is a really good thing.
No, I don't.
I do not want to be doing hundreds of Mythic Dungeons.
Neither do I, mate. I get what you're saying, and neither do I, but the fact of the matter is, that was supposed to be...
Oh, it's after the next week.
Like,
it's just
to see
the first
how far
week.
You can get. Yeah, and it should be a bracket of, like, gear in this, like, bracket, gear in this bracket.
Oh, no, it doesn't work like
bracket.
That, no. It'll, after Mythic plus 10, that's what then the max level gear.
I'm already mostly 850 anyway.
Yeah, in fact, I've lowered mine. I've gone down to 846. Yeah, it can still be Warforged and Titanforged, though, which keeps Shade the Nerd involved. But yeah, it's raid release. Shade the World Quest Master.
The World Quest Master?
Yeah, our MT, if we can say that, in our guild is a World Quest Master, including the PvP ones.
Does them all?
Oh, very much enjoy. Uri
Day.
Uri Day. Nice. His class hall resources are crisp. Through the roof. Absolutely tremendous. Has 900 world quests done. Amazing. No, I'm really happy they're doing that because, in fact, my raid leader was telling me, he's like, no, we're going to be doing loads and loads of mythics. And I was like, No. You are.
Yeah.
I'm busy. I don't mind doing all my mythics every week, but not never-ending amount of mythics.
Oh, no.
Because how many people had plans to fucking do different rune keys for different individual members of the guild and split them all up and all that? So they're going to loot cap it. I think Karazhan loot's been revealed to be 850 as well, which is... Oh,
I don't like this.
They're trying to slow down the loot progression and make content itself more important, is what I'm seeing here. Is then they're trying not to run into, like, we just did Legacy of Wrath, right? So we ran into that big issue in Wrath of Lich King, which a lot of people forgot about unless you were there at the time, where we had this amazing instance of Ulduar, and then they released TOC, but because of the expected loot improvements, TOC was just considerably better than doing Ulduar, and considerably faster, and so on and so on, and therefore it dwarfed it immediately.
Aren't you going to get that with Mythic Plus and Karazhan if you're getting the same level loot?
Well, no, because it's all side grades for the most part. I mean, it's slightly higher if you get Warforged and Titanforged and whatnot, but it's supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be a little bit of fun. That's what the idea is.
Yeah,
you
I
can
get
880 from your chest.
Well, Karazhan was the linchpin of the reveal.
Yeah, Karazhan is like a normal raid, is what they're calling
it. But then we're not getting any sort of improvement from it. It's just there for fun. The reveal's a bit of fun.
See, look how angry you are about that.
I know.
Why?
Because even I don't expect a massive gear increase. Absolutely not. But just a couple of levels to show that it's a progression line and it's not like it's going forward, sideways. Fuck that. I don't want side grades. I want upgrades. I want to progress through the content. I want my gear to, like, even like just the visual of like your gear changing as you're progressing through the expansion, even if the item level's just
a minor
upgrade.
Remember, this is only a temporary. It's not a raid. The Trial of Valor is the new raid. Thing, isn't it? Yeah, it's a 5-man thing. So it should be something you add into your mythic table, which will probably be more beneficial than doing anything else.
Apparently there's a Karazhan attunement.
Yes, there's a Karazhan attunement. What does that involve? Don't know. If it's based on what we've seen for the Nighthold, it's pretty shit, right? You go down to Azuring, you do a couple of mythics, and then you get it done. Which is pretty... That's all right. I mean, yeah, it's 10 high, but it's the same as the normal. Yeah. The same as the Nighthold, essentially.
Jack's got it right, mate. I want a longer dick, not a wider one.
No, girth is... crisp.
Yeah, but if you've got a chode, mate, you got a dick shaped like a dish plate.
Oh, otherwise you might traumatise that pussy.
Exactly. Terrorise, mate.
Nope.
Stop saying traumatise. You triggered me with that yesterday.
Unfortunately.
When you went traumatise that pussy.
Unfortunately, some people have had experience.
Oh, shit!
Unfortunately, some people have done that.
I hate how you can use that like a medal now. You piece of shit. I don't like it, mate. Go away. It's funny, though. Look at your face, the smugs. I hate you.
Some people just...
I'm gonna knife you during the break.
Some people just have moments in life that happen to them, which are ace.
Prick.
Okay, we can bring this up there. So, yes, my wife did have surgery this week. Obviously, we didn't say anything. I'm not telling the story.
All right, okay.
It was a cancer scare, unfortunately, which was really shitty. Which we found out... Fucking bollocks, man. We found out during James's birthday. Because you remember we had the birthday party here?
Yeah.
She had to go out and get a scan because she had some pain and stuff. And she come back and she was like, she took me upstairs and she started crying. I was like, uh-oh. And she was like, yeah, they found lumps. I was like, oh, no. And that was weeks ago.
Yeah.
Weeks ago. So we had to live with that fucking hanging over our heads. And the doctors couldn't do a fucking thing to double check it or confirm it for weeks. So we went to... you see... This is how you generally do it, is you wait. But we had a cancer scare. So last week we found out it wasn't cancer. Sweet. And she had a simple surgery to correct the issue on Tuesday?
Mm-hmm.
Or was it Wednesday? It was Wednesday, wasn't it?
Yes.
Which is pretty funny, though, because they had to put her in a general anesthetic for it. I left here about 1 o'clock with her to go and get surgery done.
Yeah.
And it was supposed to be about 5 hours and back home. The general anesthetic, because she's so slim, is she this here? What happened to your bladder? Your bladder went to sleep and she couldn't wee. Ah! I could joke about it now because it's all over with. Yay!
Bet she's sat in the front room on a phone, mate. They're talking about me. I'm going in.
No,
you're talking about me?
I wasn't.
But you're off work for 2 weeks now, aren't you? Messed you up a bit, didn't it? Well, that was horrible, wasn't it? Thinking about cancer for that long. Mm. That wasn't nice, was it? No, it wasn't. Okay. So that's why, anyway. So we didn't say anything, because obviously we didn't know what was going on. It's as simple as that. Magic music. Emma's going to be pissed. No, I didn't say anything, like, traumatic.
I knew you was going to do it! I'm done!
He said dinner.
I didn't say...
He's, like, he's skirting around the brag, but he's not actually said it.
Might as well just get your dick out on the desk.
I wouldn't want to traumatise anyone.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Prick. You do look like, don't you look like dead small on the screen right now?
Tiny, aren't you? With your sleepy bladder. You were busting, weren't you? They had to put a tube in and then this bag of piss started forming.
Nine hundred mils
of piss.
Within about 20 seconds.
Yeah. It was kind of funny to see, though. I was watching it. You know what I'm like? I'm a big nerd for this stuff. Wouldn't let me come in for the surgery, though, mate. Bullshit. I ended up watching Dave in Emma's room. I had to sit and watch Dave.
No Wi-Fi?
No. They did have Wi-Fi. One bar.
Smoked salmon and poached eggs for
you. Oh, yeah, really?
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. I didn't get anything, though. Didn't even offer
me. No Wi-Fi, though. What a travesty.
It was a joke.
I think local. That's cookie bread.
Yeah, you could have granary.
Granary.
White,
bread.
Brown. No black, though.
What'd you go with?
I didn't get offered anything.
Granary.
I wasn't
granary.
The patient.
Yeah.
Good choice, mate. Good choice.
I was not offered a damn thing by the menu guy. So I just sat there watching Dave.
By Dylan.
The what?
Dylan, he was called.
Oh,
Dylan.
My God, I'm roasting.
Please tell me you put a voice on. You had a guy called Dylan.
He was very down to earth and very soft spoken. He came in and he went, would you like anything for your post-op meal? How about a sandwich or some soup? The soup of the day is creme brulee. He was very sexy.
I only got bread.
Mate, why didn't you... That was prime for him to be quiet and you just break the ice walking out. Hey, Dylan!
Hey, no. The guy was about 15. He was the spot master. I'm leaving him alone, yeah. Hospital Wi-Fi is garbage. Yeah, it was a nice hospital though we went to, wasn't it? It was really good. And they treated you really nice.
In Manchester?
Yeah, it was called The Spire.
Ooh. Nice.
Ooh, The Spire. Well, that's what happened because we had this hanging over our heads. Emma's job comes with healthcare, so we phoned it and they were like, yeah, okay, we'll see. And they got you seen about 4 days. If we'd stayed with the NHS, we still wouldn't have had anything done and just been sat around with all this fucking shit floating over our heads, which has been bobbins. But that was pretty good. So that's sorted. Same side hospital, Keck. Yeah. Emma wouldn't even have the kids there.
We had our kids there.
Brave.
No, in fairness, mate, the maternity unit at same side is fucking crisp. The rest of it is just, it's arseholes. Arseholes, mate. My mum used to be the manager of it there.
Oh, she did. Yeah, she did.
Yeah, she was the manager of A&E for like 15 years. Yeah. I mean, this was a long time ago when it was less skeggy. But that was it, mate. My mum left and it went down the shit pan.
Emma's not getting a chair. Not if you're going to sit there, stand there like a teapot.
Do you want to take my place for a minute?
No.
I was trying to wind you.
Emma's got her own show on Patreon. That's the Emma show.
Has she?
No, we did it the other day, didn't we?
With the Proc
Paladin.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Anyway, moving on. So our transmod comp, we're going to have a transmod comp, but we're going to change it up. So the reasons we're changing it is pretty simple. What we're going to do is, over the course of all the transmod competitions, it's always been the case that there are certain items people try and make work and struggle. So there's two things to achieve here. One, try and get some creativity and obviously way reduce the amount of transmogs to the point where we can't show them all, which sucks. What we're going to do is give you an item and then you can play with it till the next web show and then we'll keep cycling around so everyone gets a turn with the right sort of item class and all that kind of stuff. So, you know what I mean? So everyone will get a fair crack, but we're just trying to reduce the amount of transmogs we get so we can look at them properly and inspire a bit of creativity. So this one was chosen by Mr. Ghost.
You are a pirate. Okay. You're hard-hearted indeed.
Sorry, I didn't know the alerts were on. We are going with what they called, Mr. Ghost.
Bloodstained Pauldrons.
The Bloodstained Pauldrons. Your challenge
is to get a nice, crispy transmog with the Bloodstained Pauldrons. Acquirable from Mount Hyjal. Mm-hmm. I think it's either the first or the second boss. So yep. You need those.
So that is the one for 2 weeks to try and get something to work with that. Which should be much easier now because you can just pick and choose all your... they're hideous. Impossible? Is it impossible? We lay down the challenge to you and obviously we'll sort some stuff.
We're not going to give you an rigged item that's rigged. Like really fucking easy to transmog.
Well, that's the point. Everyone tries to throw stuff in that just doesn't work. So we're trying to... I'm a priest. Don't worry, we'll have all the different classes and stuff. So it should be interesting. We hope so. We hope it'll be interesting. Yeah, clothies will be next. We'll go through it, everyone. Don't worry about it. So we're going to start with plate. And then the next one will be leather or something. We might do two at a time. Something along those lines. We might mix it in. We're just giving it testing at the moment. Is finding items that people try and use in transmogs that always fail. And whether or not we can actually... Mm-hmm. Get it to work. That's what we're hoping to do. So that's the idea behind that. So let us see. Just send it to preachgaming@gmail.com with transmog as your stuff and we'll get that done. I'll tell you what I tried. Has anybody else tried it? The pre-character testing before you boost.
Oh, you tried it the other day, didn't you?
It's really interesting. Yeah. Except that the warrior has to play arms. Fail from the very get-go.
I'm looking for a tank, but I don't know if warrior is the one that I'm going to use my boost on, so I'll give it a try.
Yeah, the warrior has to play arms, and you start with absolutely no spells, and then you get them, like, given to you in a little scenario. It's really cool. So the warrior one's on a boat, which is really cool. Yeah, it's awesome. Mage has to play frost. That's all right. Arms, though. Arms is the best DPS. Not playing it.
Not playing it?
No.
Why? Not like it.
What, arms?
Yeah.
No.
Why?
I don't know. Try it and see what you think. maybe you'll find it incredibly engaging. I bet you don't.
I'm sensing by your tone. <mate. laughs>
Yeah, it's really cool, but they go from, they give you like four, the only problem with it is they give you like four spells, and then they throw you straight into the Broken Isle scenario, which I think is fine, I guess. But I would like to like be in a pick whether you're going to be a tank or you want to try a prop warrior.
That's what I mean, yeah.
Yeah, you want to try Fury Warrior, you want to try a prop warrior, because most people aren't going to play around with just arms or something. For new players, I go, is it enough?
No.
Is it enough? What does prop warrior get? It gets Mortal Strike, Colossus Smash, Whirlwind, Victory Rush. I think that's it. I think that's all they get. I like arms, I have two. At some point, I lose faith in the chat. At some point. I'm swing time of fun.
It took you now and to lose faith?
No.
I lost faith.
I love most of my chat. Except you.
And you.
Yeah, the pre-character testing was fucking really cool. I was so surprised how it worked out. Just then it threw me straight into... it throws you straight into the bro, because I was going undercover, so I needed characters that didn't work called Preach. So that was why I had to do it, because obviously going in undercover as Preach would have been a bit of a fucking giveaway. So that's why I was making new characters for, which is very, very cool. Do you got? Yeah, your gear has the other bags in it.
Did we give your character a funny name?
Yeah, so Cleft. Oh, I'm a cleft.
I'm a cleft.
I'm a cleft. I'm a cleft. I'm a cleft. I'm a cleft, which is the best name ever. Right, then the last thing I had on my notes was balance. What do you guys think? Are we giving up on balance till like 6 months?
No.
I kind of put my case forward in the video yesterday.
We've not had specifics, but we've already heard that the bros are getting a nerf.
You?
For our trash damage, mate. Yeah,
not the trash damage.
Yeah, do you know Nightmare. Why? Do you know why that's a problem? Because the game's filled with absolute bullshit munchers who see trash damage and think, well, they need a nerf. That's a ticket.
Where's my trash damage?
Yeah, I spec'd my Demon Hunter purely for trash damage,
which means barrage.
Which means barrage, mate. Yeah, barrage and momentum. So I do a dick load of damage on trash. When it comes to a boss, I get wrecked. But on trash, mate, it's crisp.
Not if you've got Metamorphosis, which is a skill spell.
It's not about the destination, mate. It's about the journey.
The journey.
Yeah?
The journey to pressing the two button meta.
So then they've already said, it's like, yeah, so we're going to nerf Fel Barrage damage. And it's just like...
And tank bros are getting nerfed, which is fine in my book. I don't know. It's going to be months, right? It's going to be months. Windwalker, look at all the jokes. Windwalker is balanced. I did, the Windwalker was putting out a solid 500k single target DPS the other day. I was with, like, fine, be that way. Be that way.
They call him the garbage man.
They call him the garbage man.
I said that when we were streaming. Just call me the garbage man.
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah, I mean, balance is needed. I'm so glad they're not doing it before raiding and Mythic Plus, though.
Let me just...
So glad.
But yeah, the one thing that actually triggered me the most is, I get it, okay? We need a fucking an AoE reduction. But,
yeah.
But the problem isn't Fel Barrage. It really isn't.
Fel Rush and stuff.
It's not just that. It's like, if you combine Fel Rush... And then, like, if you turn around and Fel Barrage, it's going to do a dick load of damage. But if you Fel Rush, turn around and I-Beam, and you've spec for I-Beam, and you've got the improved stats through your artifact into I-Beam, that one ability alone will beat everyone else's damage.
But you're skilled, though. Like, when I press Living Bomb.
But that's what I mean, though. But, like, it's like, you know, so we've noticed the problems with Fel Barrage. It's like, it's not. No, it isn't.
Well, they're trying to do it. So, because it does matter on bosses that have a lot of trash. You know, that have a lot of ads and stuff. Yeah, they will need to balance out.
So what you're saying, mate, is the trash man's still got a job.
What I did say, though, is they can't hammer certain specs into the ground, right? They can't do that. I mean, they can't.
They will, though.
Well, they might do, but if you're a pure DPSer, like a Lock, lol. I'm sorry, Locks. I do feel for you. But if you've been... well, Locke's a bad example, actually. But if you're a pure spec that has had to invest all your AP into one spec, they can't hammer that into the ground, man. Because people will just be like, fuck this game, I'm out. If they, like, hammered that down to the ground... Because everyone's about 100,000 plus spec. AP now, right? Because we've unlocked braces.
No, mate. Belt.
Oh, belt.
Did you get your belt? I got mine yesterday.
Yeah, but I don't need it, so.
I need it for my transmog, don't mate. Sorry.
Fair enough. Yeah, they can't really hammer that into the ground, can they? Lost, what a joke. Pure BM, mate. So they're stuck. They're really stuck for so long on proper balancing. Because the relics themselves make such a fucking difference. What's your relics now? Are they bollocks? Have you got good relics?
Mine is shit relics just for the item level.
Yeah, well, you got to get your item level up, haven't you, mate?
Well, that's what I mean.
You got to get your item level up.
Exactly.
Otherwise, you'll just look like a prick.
If I mean, because the thing is, as well, is what I'm doing now is going to be completely different from when I'm raiding. I'm not going to have the trash man spec. You know, it's going to be more of a single target, which means that I need more, glaive toss damage, eye beam damage, and stuff like that. I don't need fucking blade dance damage, fell barrage damage. I don't need that or increased amount of rage or fury, whatever the fuck it's called.
Yes, call me. I know there's certain groups that wouldn't invite me because I've dropped mine. You won't get in groups with that item. That's what I'm saying. Because I can have 851, I think, but I've dropped it down to 846. I'm pretty sure there are certain groups that wouldn't bring me because of that. They'd be like, dude, you is bad at this game.
Yeah.
You is real bad. And therefore, no, mate, to getting mythics. Because mythic zero is serious and that. Because it's heroics. And you need a special group. And then we also saw there's a thread going around. It was on MMO Champions where it started, and it spread to the WoW forums. Where because people are losing their mind because Mythic Dungeon has Mythic in front of it, ergo it's incredibly hard.
Sorry, go on.
People recommending that healers start charging for runs.
Charging?
Gold. 10k plus. To pug mythics.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm fucking not. People are recommending to do that, and there are servers where this habit is picking up.
Do you know what we need? We need like a good...
Fuck my life,
we need
right?
like a good, a strong global epidemic that will wipe out these kind of people from...
As a healer, I agree. I'm fucking serious. There are servers where this is taking off as a trend. Because it's called Mythic, so it's dead
the
hard,
the thing is,
right?
if I Hearthstone to Dalaran, and I'm doing stuff in Dalaran, if I see anything in trade chat now, I don't single people out, it's partially because I'm an arsehole. If I see anyone say... Like, I'm not even going to touch mythics now. I'm going to say heroics. Anyone say, you know, looking for a healer for spamming heroics 840 plus, right? I immediately whisper that person with some absolute heinous things. Like, are you that fucking insecure and shit that you need that kind of fucking gear level?
Look at the healers. I ain't moving for 50k. I ain't moving for 50k.
I don't get out of bed, mate, unless it's 10k in my fucking coin purse.
The things the community does to each other. To make their own experience worse. Yeah. Blows my mind. Yeah. Like, will try and ruin their own gaming experience. Because the healers, the guy who's like playing his healer will be like, yeah, it's well good, get 10k. Then one day he makes a DPS ult, and then all the healers are asking for money. He'll be like, that's bullshit, though. It's disgusting. It's absolutely gross. How many people wreck the game for themselves? You are mental. You don't think about it at all. People selling mythic dungeon runs for 40k.
Well, if someone off is a question
it's,
for
it's
you,
it's so easy.
Is a question for you. You need to do mythics anyway. Someone whispers you, it's like, look, we've got a mythic group. We need you to heal. I'll give you 40k.
You're not going to say no.
Exactly.
But these people are saying, we'll heal mythics.
But if you say no, then to that healer, I mean, like someone who's like less, like.
And
he's
bound to be shit.
Here's
you know
thing.
He can't dispel.
Here's the thing. Now imagine that in that fucking healer's head. That's going to spread like wildfire.
That's what's happening. This is what's happening. I've seen it. I've seen a couple of examples of it across the US forums and the EU forums and on MMO lol. And this is a thing. It's ruining it for everybody. For themselves, which is just fucking
solution,
mind-blowing.
Get into a fucking stable
doesn't matter
stable
what
guild.
Blizzard does.
You need to get into a stable guild. Here's the thing. You can't be a mercenary now. Unless
is that how they consider themselves?
No, this is what I'm putting it into. You can't be a mercenary like a fucking a lone wolf type character now. Unless you are utility, if you're a tank or a healer. You can't be a DPS on your... You need a fucking guild these days. If this is the shit that's going down, think of how much worse it's going
to
get.
Well, perhaps Blizzard has done something to make that happen. Stay tuned for Monday's video. One guy paid me 50k the other day.
And you're going to take it? Obviously you're going to take it. It's 50 fucking grand for a mythic.
What is going on sometimes?
Bullshit munchers, mate.
What is going on?
But there's the thing is though, this isn't this itself isn't Blizzard's fault. It's just some fucking it's a disease. It's someone who's just put this out there. The healer's obviously taken that on board, then someone will whisper that healer, or he's whispered someone who's looking for you. It's like, yeah, I'll do it if you give me 40k.
Jesus.
And that's how it's branched out, mate. That's how it's spread.
It's just the word mythic. That's all it's done it.
You know what's good,
the word mythic has just blown people into like it's some sort of hardcore elite content.
Yeah.
That's all it had to be was we called it mythic and everyone believed it was elite content. Like, that's heavy stuff. That drops like...
Mythic, mate.
What level of gear is it in there?
Same level that you can get from World Quests.
Is it like 835 base?
No, I think it's 840 is mythic base. 840. You can get daily quests.
Such trash gear, right? Where is this gear? Such trash.
You can get 820. Such trash. It's got the chance of upgrading to 840. You can get 835 plus. It's got the chance of going up to 845. But mythics are dropping 840 and you need at least 840 gear score and 40k to pay your healer.
Fucking
you
buddy.
Fucking cocksuckers. Fuck you, come back down to earth, you fucking cloud chasing cocks.
That's why Orange still, in many people's eyes, Orange still carries that it's a legendary item. It's trash. Most of them are fucking trash, man. Absolute trash. Like, the chat was so triggered when I said, like, the other day when I was dropping my item level down for stats. I was like, yeah, but I gained, like, 10% more crit. They were like, yeah, but what about your item level? And that's the number one question I get asked. What is your item level? And then I go 846, and they go, lol, blah, 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 it's 851, mate.
Do you know what I like about shit like that? So it's like, okay, do you want a DPS alongside me? And then see how big of a mouth you got after it, mate. Do you want to go up against the trash, man?
That's the balance, isn't it? Because it doesn't matter. What if you've got more? This is why I'm saying it's going to be 6 months before the spirit of... I hope and pray the spirit of competition comes back into WoW at some point for raiding. Because right now, it's a clusterfuck. And it will be for a while. Because it's AP, it's relics, it's gear, it's talents. It's all that stuff is a clusterfuck all over the place. So let's just hope and pray that at some point, probably in the next two raid tiers, we can actually have some relevant competition. That would be nice. Because other than that, we're starting to run out of reasons to raid. For me, anyway, who likes the spirit of competition, I want to be able to compete, you know what I mean, against other people and see how we're performing. But you can't at the moment. You just can't do that. So on the topic of selling out, we've sold out big time. We're going to be in that Birmingham. Oh, no, you might not be going, though.
I am going.
I don't think you are.
You fucking kidding me?
They won't give us more spots. In fact, Emma will confirm this for us.
Fuck them then.
Yeah, I know. So I might... The plan was EGX 2016. EGX 2016 in Birmingham, which is next weekend. Twitch has asked us to go and stream down there. And Intel as well. So I'll be streaming for Intel. So I'll be there on the Saturday. But it's completely sold out. So if you don't have a ticket, sorry. I only found out yesterday that they only requested that we go down to stream yesterday. I'm going to be streaming with somebody else. What's her name?
Oh, it's a chick, isn't it,
mate? It is a girl. I've never seen her stream, so I'll have to check it out. Dajari, I think it's called. She's called. Grill. Did you stream with a grill? Yeah, I've never watched the stream. Yeah, Dajari, two eyes, DJARII. Who is it?
Apparently it's Skull's girlfriend.
Oh, is Scott going to be down there? That'd be nice. Skull's lady? Okay. So, yeah, I'll be streaming Dajari on the Twitch stage, and then I'll be doing the Intel booth later in the day. So if you have a ticket, you'll see me on the Saturday. If you don't have a ticket, it's sold out, so bummerino. We're also going to be in London around the 12th of October. Now, as far as I know, that event isn't sold out, but at the same time, I'm not allowed to tell you what it is yet, which is a bit of a bummer. But it's a total troll by Blizzard. It is going to be on behalf of Blizzard, and they're trolling us big time. So, yeah, we'll be down in that London to do that. And then we're going to be at BlizzCon. So, yeah, we're doing all that kind of stuff coming up in the next few weeks.
Yeah!
So that's going to be pretty good. So hopefully we'll get to meet and greet a few of you guys. Although, unfortunately, one of them is sold out. Which sucks balls, but yeah, should be fun. We've got some fun stuff in London to do, haven't we? Some really silly stuff. You can't remember, can you?
I can't remember.
You
no.
can't remember at all.
Yeah, I do remember.
There
yeah,
you go. There you go. You can't remember. Blizzard trolling me and Andy specifically as. So I hopefully should announce what that's going to be and where you can come and meet us if you're in London, because I think the place only holds about 200 people, and it's going to be a booze up. It's going to be a booze up with me and the lad. So if you want to get boozed up with me and the lad, I think there's some cosplayers going and stuff like that. It should be pretty fucking swag. Should be pretty swag. So we'll let you know on that one as soon as we can. But I will be in Birmingham. It might just be me. It might be Andy. We're trying to work it out. Because we were hoping to have me, you, and Emma go down. And then go on the Razzle Dazzle in Birmingham at the night time, mate. But apparently there's some issue with tickets.
Cunts, mate. Cunts, you organise it. Cunts, mate.
I think we were at the last minute.
I'm fucking going now anyway, regardless. Cut me off it. Done.
Right, let's take a quick break and then we'll have some drama. Maybe we'll play some games. Let's see how I'm feeling in a second. So we'll be back in a minute. So I'll put some Edgelord on for you. Or maybe Ghosty can.
All right, Preach is going to be just be 2 minutes. He's putting some sort of heat pad device on Emma. Is it a heat pad? No, it's thrombosis stocks. So, you know... There's that going on, which is good. Apparently as well, we're on BlizzCon. We're going to be there Thursday night, just 5 minutes walk from where BlizzCon's going to be, mate. We're going to be at Tony Roma's, mate, having some of them buffalo wings and them cold pints. So if you're there at BlizzCon the Thursday night, get in there, mate. Get yourself a nice little Chardonnay. We'll have a nice little chat. How's that sound, mate? My wrists, Andy. What do you do to your wrists? Probably don't want to know. Bring back Edge. No, don't bring back Edge. Overrated wrestler, mate. Bad wrestler. Trigger that. Edgelord, mate. All about the edges. Throbbing bosses, more like. I don't know what to say to that. You don't skip Slipknot. You do. Slipknot's not the same without Joey Jordison, let's be honest. Prepare your flank jackets for London's... London is... Oh, my God. Get out, you prick. Cold pint. Cut myself 19 times during the break. A nice Merlot. Nice.
Oh, the thrombosis has been cured. We're safe. We're safe. So, yeah, glory. Right, I've picked a drama story which will be very suitable for you guys. I think you're going to like it.
How suitable?
You're going to like this. It's relevant, is what I'll say. I'm looking forward to Tony Roma's. Apparently, we don't land till 9 p.m, so we might be a little bit later we get there. And, what's it called? The airport.
Wasn't it the John Wayne airport?
The John Wayne, mate.
Renthar, drive and pick us up from the airport.
No, I like it. We get in with them the taxi drivers who tell us that they hate everywhere. Right, I need two names, bruv.
Two names? You got it, mate. Okay, the colour bind... No, okay. Chaos Pike.
In fact, we need one name.
Okay, Chaos Pike. Fuck, I've just seen the name Sweaty Beaver.
I'll go with Sweaty Beaver. Thanks, I'll put Chaos Pike into a different one.
Okay.
Sweaty Beaver. One sec. No, I'm not. Nice. No, I'm not. I'm shivering constantly, even though it's not cold, which is great. I hate being ill. Pain in the ass. I'm sure it's the kids as well, fuckers. Because it's only us two in the office. How do we get ill?
Well, you got ill, mate, and then you passed out to me.
Yeah, probably, but I assume it's the kids. Right then. Here we go. Are you bad, mate? Are you bad? Holla Preacher, this is my first Drama Time submission and I'm sending it to you all the way from down under me, Melbourne.
Australia?
Australia.
Hooroo?
Sheila's Wheels.
Oh my God, mate.
Foster's.
Got ourselves a little fucking drama here, I see you can't.
You sound like Jim Jefferies.
Bonza.
I want to be Russell Crowe.
No one wants to be Russell Crowe.
Oh, I'd be fighting all around the world.
Oi.
Have you watched that now? It's so
you showed
good.
It, me.
So good. Fighting all around the world with his boat tugger. This happened just yesterday on Legion. It's a short story, but one that will hopefully entertain. To start with, I play a Rep Paladin.
Rip.
After watching your videos and playing the class for myself in pre-patch, I considered re-rolling for Legion. But as the number of days until the expansion shone, I just couldn't pry myself away from playing the Rep Paladin. I have played this character since the Burning Crusade, and raided from Wrath of the Lich King onwards. I only ever played a different class in 6.2, which was a Frost Mage.
Setting the bar pretty low then.
There was a recent meme posted on Reddit. That sounds bizarre. Bold statement. Reddit would never post memes. Which perfectly illustrates how applying for Mythic Dungeons in LFG as a Rep Paladin generally goes. I'm about to open Reddit, ladies and gentlemen. Fingers crossed. This is a dick.
This is a
if this is a dick, Being a rat in Legion. I haven't seen this. Need tank has been declared. Let me put it on the show. I don't get it. I don't think. Look. Maymays.
It's a Maymay.
Right, here we go. What does it say? Need tank has been declined. Kamara Mythic plus 835 has been declined. Your application to has been declined. Your application to need DPS has been declined. Your application to Mythic 835 all leather has been declined. Your application to Mythic 825 has been declined. Your application to 840 Vault of the Wardens has been declined. The application to Rush 630 has been declined. And your application to need DPS BOP please has been declined.
BOP please.
That sounds like the best group. I would certainly try and join the beat overpowered.
Do you know what I feel sorry for at the minute? And it's just from like what I've read of people in Guild and people in local is Affliction Locks, man.
Yeah. I feel bad for my raid leader's had to go 16, 16, 16 as a minimum in all his weapons. And now he's doing the rest of it after that. Not me, though. I understand that people don't want shitty classes in their pugs. However, spending an hour trying to find a group is not fun. Especially when I still managed to out deeps other classes. I managed to get into a group for, wait for it, More of Souls Mythic, mate.
Pretty edgy name.
In the group finder, it was listed as the following, ladies and gents. LFM, More, 840 plus, don't be bad. Don't be bad. Right? Okay. What do they expect people to say? Are you bad?
No.
Alright, okay. Remember, I am a desperate for any group that will take me, no matter how ridiculous the advertisement. The group leader, a guardian druid called Sweaty Beaver, immediately begins talking in party chat. What does he say, Andy?
Are you bad?
Now, you said that with too much grammar. It's written as it is in the title.
Are you bad?
Are you bad, mate? Are you bad?
Answer me.
Are you bad? At first, I wasn't sure if he was talking to me, so I just ignored it. I received a summons to the instance and ran inside. Instead of starting to pull the trash, however, Sweaty Beaver turns towards and targets me, and then he asks again, dude, are you bad?
Are you bad, mate?
Are you bad, though? Dude, are you bad? Are you bad though? Because this is Mythic and that. Not fucking about now, mate. More of Souls. Are you bad? Still not sure if he's being serious. I reply, no, I'm a rep paladin. Just don't be bad though. He replied. Just don't be bad. Are you bad? Don't be bad. I'm asking you questions.
Jesus Christ.
Just don't be bad. He continues. Oh, you're getting kicked? So sick of scrubs you can't play, though. Wait a minute. Let me ask you one thing, though. Are you bad? Don't be bad or I'll kick you. Fucking idiot. It seemed as if Sweaty Beaver might have been a bit of a cunt. Wait a minute. Let me check my cunt meter.
Yep. Jesus Christ.
Off the charts, man. Off the charts. However, I was confident enough in my own skills to not see this particularly threatening. So I just said, all right. Alright. Maybe he'd come from a shitty group and didn't want to repeat the same thing. You know what I mean? Just thinking outside the box. Maybe Sweaty Beaver's had a bad experience.
Yeah.
We start to kill the first boss. At around 40%, Sweaty Beaver dies by running into several of the deadly purple orbs.
No, it weren't Sweaty Beaver, mate, was it? No, Sweaty Beaver's person one.
No, Sweaty Beaver. That's correct.
Okay, sorry, mate.
I've done this before.
Sweaty Beaver's the Are You Bad one.
Are You Bad, mate?
That's Sweaty Beaver.
That's Sweaty Beaver. Sounds he's like a guardian Beaver, druid, mate. Yeah. And Sweaty Beaver dies on that first boss. Now, let's be fair, ladies and gents. That first boss in More of Souls, though, it's pretty tough, right?
Refresh me.
He's got a fear, right, that's really hard to see. And stuff moves in a circle. It's pretty tough, mate. Pretty tough. It's pretty tough. You got to focus on it. So are you bad though? Sweaty Beaver's got an answer. Sorry guys, was packing a bong lol.
Ray. 420 me.
Of course I die because I'm fucking cool as fuck.
Blaze it, mate.
I'm the kind of tank that packs bongs during the boss. That's because I'm not bad. Was the reply he gave. With mega heals from the healer and self-healing from myself, we still managed to kill the boss. Although we all died at the same time as he died. Everyone releases spirit and runs back. Except for Sweaty Beaver, though, who rocks a... Rest, please. I'm the tank, though. I ain't fucking running. Oi! Resme?
No.
You bad, though.
You bad.
How are you going to do it without a tank? Resme? Not even fucking thinking. The healer obliges, not without saying. It's like 10-second walk, bro. Sweaty Beaver doesn't respond, though, bros. Instead, just saying a generic TY. We loot the boss. I get an 840 trinket. God, I'm hot. It's surpassed by the two I already have. One's an 820 blue from the Vault of Wardens. Nah, can't be better. You are not talking fucking science, mate. How can a blue be better than a purple, you dickhead? Fucking stupid. You are bad. He is bad. Proof is in the pudding, mate. Proof is a blue be better than a purple. Fucking retard, mate. And although that trinket's considered pre-raid best in slot for rep pallies and an 850 mythic titan forge trinket in my other slot, I offer it instead to the warrior DPS. But guess what, though? Sweaty Beaver chimes in. Hang on a minute. Back up. I see what's going on here. You're bad. Let me educate you. What the fuck, rep pally, he says. Just take it and replace that shitty blue you've got.
Fuck off with the face. I hate you.
I explained to him that it gives better stats and abilities than this new one. But Sweaty Beaver uses science. Dude, it's higher item level. I don't think you've noticed something pretty important about that trinket, though. Because you're bad. It's that it's a higher item level. Ergo, way better. You no, fit cunt. I told him, okay, and equipped it. Fully intending to unequip it again once I'd left the group. You were a bit of a bitch at that point, to be fair.
Yeah, mate. To be honest, you gave in.
You were a bit of a bitch at that point, mate. We continue through the dungeon wiping 5 times. More of Souls is like 5 minutes long, bro.
And it's not very difficult.
People would pull extra trash, DPS not killing the adds on the second boss. All the while, Sweaty Beaver went into serious detail about his hookah weed. This is purple haze, mate. Sticky green.
The fucking stickiest of icky.
Are you bad, mate?
Are you?
Or have you got sticky sticks?
Mate.
Let me tell you all about my weed, though.
Show me a kush.
I have nothing against stoners, only dickheads who constantly need to brag about their hobby to other people.
I fucking hate that. I immediately, like, you know that scene in Family Guy when someone's like...
Vape Nation.
Yeah, not even Vape Nation. Vape Nation is different, but when someone's saying, yeah, I'm just we're going to fucking smoke a bowl, mate. Oh, I've just smoked a bowl. And I immediately think, you're like a montage of me putting my headset down, getting out of my house, cornering down a taxi, going to the airport, flying to this dickhead's house, and then just, like, smashing him with a bat.
Some people say, be right back, 1 minute. Other people say, be right back, rolling myself a blunt.
Yeah. It's like, give it up, mate. Do you know what? It's lost that cool factor now that it's starting to be legal. You're not a rebel anymore, you're just a cunt.
Wait, though. We then got to the mini-boss before Helia and wiped. How the fuck do you wipe on that? I was the only one interrupting his spell, frequently having to watch him cast it as my interrupt remained on cooldown. Interrupt the boss, idiots, said Sweaty Beaver. That was it. I left the group. I didn't give enough of a shit about the loot for one more boss to justify staying. Plus, we probably wouldn't have been able to kill Helia anyway. Aww. Helia too tough, mate. I got sent one last message, though, from Sweaty Beaver after leaving. He sent me the DPS meter and added, "You're bad, mate."
Read what it says.
You dog shit.
There you go.
you dog shit. And I'm smoking weed.
I am so fucking blazed, mate.
I'm so blazed and you're dog shit. Either he hadn't read them or didn't care regardless, because I was actually second in the charts, only about 3 to 4K behind our Fury Warrior. Linking the wrong meters is the best thing ever. I nearly got kicked from a group for that, because a guy didn't know how to use a DPS meter, so he'd left it on, like, accumulated forever and believed he was literally rocking the entire group on DPS. I was on a Hunter, and he's going, Hunter, do more damage. I was like, what the fuck? I'm top of the deeps. And he's like, do more damage though, mate. And then he said, let's bolt kick the Hunter. He's clearly AFK. And people are like, no, he's not. And he's like, yeah, he is. And then he linked his damage meter that he'd had on for probably 3 days. And he's like, look at my damage compared to him, though. And he's like, dude, you're so fucking motherfucker. I hope you enjoyed my little story. And remember, guys, don't be bad.
Don't be bad, mate.
Don't be bad.
Do not be bad.
Don't be bad. There you go, mate. I thought it fit the themes.
Little story. I was hoping it was going to end nicely, you know, like in terms of this guy sort of like set his face on fire with his bong or something. But it was a nice story nonetheless, mate. I like it.
I think it sums it up everywhere. The whole mythic thing has driven people absolutely insane.
It's the name.
Absolutely insane. I can't believe it. All they had to do was change the name and it just fucked everybody up completely. Right then, ladies and gents, do you want to ask us some questions or do you want us to play a little VR? Wow. Because we're not staying up long because I'm dying.
You are dying, mate. I feel for you.
You don't give a shit.
No, I do feel for you because I'm looking at you thinking this is... You're like five days away from me, so in 5 days I'm going to be dicks out.
Dicks out. Dicks out. And they've pushed back the fucking South Park game, which is a motherfucker.
I know, right? Right. It's good though because we can switch dates around for titles that are released on that date.
Right.
Dead Rising 4 is out as well.
We've got a couple of things. We do have a VR horror game, but it's only about 5 minutes long.
We should do that first anyway, then, shouldn't we? In fairness. You know.
Oh, we've got Andy who can stab and kill things. So, it's your choice. Mike, welcome to the squad.
Mate. I want to see you. I want to see you in the horror thing. It's always fun for people to watch. And it might scare a bit of that fever
out of you. It's only apparently 5 minutes long, so I'll go first and get it out of the way.
Let's just do that, then.
Yes, you should. Mm. It's only a short one. There's no real VR games coming out, horror games coming out at the moment. We've played most of them. There was one where I had to sit at a table and not move my hands, but it didn't look like it was very graphically good, so I didn't bother.
Refresh people about the new transmog competition.
The transmog competition is the Bloodstained Pauldrons from Hai Zhal. Try and do a good transmog with them. And send it to preachgaming@gmail.com.
Do you want me to get the share, mate? Can you push mine back to my desk? Delightful. Delightful. Right, we're going to have to do a bit of audio tweaking. You're in two, aren't you? Your drink is here, mate, if you want it. I'm going to put that there so I don't slurp up and drink more of your badness. So we'll do a mic check when he's on. I'm going to adjust the camera. There we go. Have you honey dicked me?
No.
Right, one sec then. I'll make a new scene.
I'm already hot.
Okay, add. Is it a screen capture or is it a game?
Yeah, try both.
Screen capture. Whap, whap, whap. No, I'm going to try game first. I think I am, you jabroni. The Dark Side, is it called?
The Bellows. The Bellows?
The Bellows. Why is this showing me the Dark Side then? What the fuck is this? Okay.
Oh, this looks great.
Don't do anything, though.
I believe we're in a graveyard.
I'm going to have to put this in the middle of the screen. Camera. Oh, shit.